para tomar el título del príncipe Naseem.
Wilfredo Vasquez, the legendary former three-time world champion, has finally got the fight he's been waiting for.
Prince Naseem, no problem.
Prince Naseem, in defense of his WBO world title, still has something to prove. Just who is the best featherweight in the world?
Naz is always explosive. Vasquez firmly believes he'll beat him.
Double trouble. Chris Eubank, the original entertainer, steps up to cruiserweight to challenge Carl Thompson, the current WBO world champion.
Eubank has to win this, otherwise it's the end.
Just who will steal the show? Double trouble. Saturday at 9, Sky Box Office 3.
But he'll be sharing the limelight with his little friend. The Prince headlines the Manchester show, and after that fracas at Heathrow, there's little love lost.
He backstabbed me. You know, as far as I'm concerned, everyone can make him king for a day. When he walks by me, he should bow his head like the little man that he is.
Eubank
nearly showed up for the pre-fight press conference, but not everybody got along. Ian Dark watched it.
After a private jet from Cornwall, Eubank's day started normally enough. Upstairs, to change into his best-dressed man image, the usual theatrical late entrance to the press conference. And then suddenly it all changed as the bitterness between Eubank and the Prince Naseem camp surfaced in a vitriolic exchange.
Naz has backstabbed me. He has been snidey towards me. He has been underhanded towards me. And anyone who treats me like that, I don't have anything to do with, whether it's visual or from a hearing point of view. You can't do that. I was kind. I showed him kindness. I showed him friendship. I tried to steer him.
Let me just jump in here. Chris tried to nick Naz off me years ago, and Naz gave him the rods. That's the problem. Chris Eubank come to my gym. I paid him £300 a week. Johnny Nelson stood him on his head. Errol Graham stood him on his head, and he wouldn't fight him. Naz has got more talent in his little finger than he's ever had. He come up to our gym and he watched Naz jump the ropes. He watched Naz strut around the place. And he went out and made a fortune. Not a problem. But in the Boxers Association down London, he got Naz when he was up at the top of the tree, got him to one side and tried to steal him off me. And Naz come out and I tell you, Eubank was lucky I didn't finish upsetting about him. I might have been 54 at the time, but he'd have been in a bleeding fight with me, and you take that from me. He's a phony.
Let me see who's who here. Do you agree with that, Frank? What he just said?
I don't know. I weren't in the court.
Okay. Do you agree with what he said, Matt?
Yeah, I agree with him.
Do you agree with him?
Not
too much. If I was a weaker man, if I was a more emotional man, I'd cry. You know, and I mean, okay, if the two of you are, well, you are a nonsense.
Right, let's stop all this now. This is getting out of hand. It's getting stupid. A question was asked, you answered it, and then Brendan said his.
He's a liar.
Let's get on to the fights. Let's talk about
the
fights.
I mean, how do you live with yourselves? You've got children. You got a wife.
Listen, Tim, you've seen her all before, which if I'd been in the gym, I paid you £300 a week. Johnny Nelson stood you on your head. Mm. He jumped out of the ring and he went, I'm not sparring with him anymore. I'm not sparring with him. I can't hear him, he won't box properly.
I'm upset. I'm upset with you know, what he's just said is rubbishing, is making a fool, a mockery out of someone. I'm a decent man. First and foremost, a decent, I don't lie, I don't cheat.
Well, an amazing outburst, and it all brings to mind, really, the mind games that Steve Collins played on Chris Eubank ahead of their first fight, which, of course, Eubank lost. You do wonder, has all this affected the psychological balance of Eubank ahead of Saturday's big fight, which he has to win to save his career?
Thanks to Ian Dark. Nicky Piper, can you interpret all that for us?
Well, I don't know the deep reasons behind the arguments there, but I do know that if this was an argument between two fighters of the same weight, we'd end up with a boxing match, and what we've got now is a clash of heavyweight egos, really. although we had on behalf of Naseem Ahmed, Brendan Ingle doing the arguing, really is upsetting. You can see it upsetting Chris Eubank, and that point was well made. Is this going to really hinder his chances on the weekend?
What about the comment that Brendan Ingle made there, that Eubank is a phony?
Well, he's not a phony. Eubank has proved himself inside the ring. I don't know what the argument outside of the ring is. I got a little bit, as everybody else did, from that. Eubank is a great fighter, always has been. I thought Brendan went a little bit too far with the, you know, really ridiculing Chris Eubank, especially mentioning figures of £300 for. It was a long, long time ago. It's been well documented that he stole the, he copied Naseem jumping into the ring over the ropes, and as Brendan said, no problem with that. But as far as much as I know, I mean, nobody knows. There's been a long clash between these two fighters and camps.
If you were a Eubank fan, nonetheless, you'd be very worried, wouldn't you, that he appears to have been undermined by a man he's not even fighting, and his manager.
Well, Carl Thompson, you could see to the left of Naseem there, sitting there rather quietly, wasn't enjoying it, although deep down must be thinking to himself, well, this is working in my favour.
How about the parallel that Ian Dark drew there, going back to the Collins fight in the super middleweight era, when Collins, we all believe, outthought Eubank before the fight had started?
Well, again, it's been done on behalf of Carl Thompson, but it could affect Chris Eubank. It'll be very interesting to see Saturday how he comes out for this fight.
Well, it's set it up, hasn't it? Surely the biggest argument of all will be, who proves showman of the night?
Chris Eubank v. Naseem Hammad. It could be the real fight of the night. Once friends, now bitter enemies.
I don't wish him bad. I wish him what he deserves. And I don't think that's going to be good, because he hasn't been good to me. You have to treat people as you find them. And so, Naz, I hope your newly wed wife gives you hell.
Yeah, but Naz, you're a nice guy, so is he.
I am a nice guy. I'm not too sure about him, you know. I'm not too sure about him. We did used to get on. We did used to be friends before. I think it got to him with all the fame and the money.
There's always been competition. Naz claims he taught Eubank his acrobatic flips. Both like their toys and strive for the ultimate performance. And no two other British fighters have been such showmen. But their friendly rivalry took a turn for the worse on Sheffield's Full Monty show, where they shared billing. Hammad won, Eubank lost. And no thanks to his little friend at ringside who shouted support for Calzaghe. Then came their tete-a-tete at Heathrow, where punches and slaps were supposedly thrown.
The airport scene, what happened, if any man tries to, like, try and slap me, he's going to get hit regardless.
I opened my hand to slap him. I wouldn't punch him. He's 5 foot, what, two?
Now they must perform together again. The theatrics front of house may well reveal their true inner feelings behind the scenes. Two fighters who help coach each other and now won't even speak.
The cardinal sin. This is fundamentally wrong. You know, this is on the hand, this is slapping, this is biting the hand that feeds you.
All Chris needs to do is give me the respect that I deserve, that a world champion deserves. That's it, basically. And until he does that, then he'll probably get some back.
Because you have, you know, it, I shouldn't really call him it, but because you have little Naseem there talking out so much, it's as though no one else existed before him. And, you know, I don't want people to forget what I've done.
There's going to be a lot of arguments Saturday night. The men with the closest view will be at ringside, Glenn McCrory and Ian Dark.
Yes, Paul, and it just strikes me that if they could ever get Chris Eubank and Prince Naseem Hammad in the same ring, they could fill Wembley Stadium about five times over. But I think even Frank Warren couldn't make that happen with a four-stone weight differential. But Eubank...